Okay, so good afternoon to all the students. Okay, in today's lecture we are going to discuss regarding to the specification of the lathe machine. Then what is meant by the CNC machine and a primary introduction to the CNC machine. Then advantages of a CNC machine, then disadvantages of that CNC machine and the application of that CNC machine. Okay, that point we will discuss in today's lecture. Okay, now see here, specification of lathe machine. Okay, before going to the specification of the lathe machine, first upon we will discuss regarding to the what is mean by the specification or what is the meaning of that specification word. Okay, simple, the meaning of that specification word is it will give the detailed information or it will give the detailed description about the dimension of that product. Okay, that specification, it will give the detailed description regarding to the dimension of your particular that products. Okay, suppose we want to purchase the any mobile from a market. Okay, then during the purchasing of that mobile, we are not directly taking the mobile from that store or from the market. Okay, before going to the purchasing the mobile, first upon we will discuss or we will see or we will observe the what are the specification of that mobile. Okay, what will be the specification of that mobile? First upon our first step of purchasing the any product is observe or do the study of that specification of that particular product. Okay, suppose we want to purchase one mobile. Okay, suppose this is the mobile is there, and suppose we want to purchase that mobile from the market, then which specification will we observe regarding to that mobile product. Okay, we will see what will be the length of that mobile, then what will be the width of that mobile, then what will be the thickness of that mobile, then what is the weight of that mobile, then regarding to the battery capacity, what is the battery capacity of that mobile, then about the camera, what is the megapascal capacity of that camera. Okay, that all information or that all information of that particular mobile is called as the specification of that product. Okay, in similar manner, okay, in that similar manner also there are the some specifications are there regarding to the lathe machine. Okay, suppose we want to purchase the lathe machine from the market, then which specification we will be see regarding to that lathe machine. See here, whenever we want to purchase the lathe machine, during that we should know the following specification or these are the following specification of that lathe machine. Okay, that this all specification, okay, see that all specification of that lathe machine, it give the detailed description regarding to the dimension of that lathe machine. Okay, see what are that different specification of that lathe machines are there. See, the first specification is distance between two center. Okay, already we are knowing that that regarding to the introduction of that lathe machine or the construction of that lathe machine, that part already we have over. In that we have seen the construction of that lathe machine, and inside that lathe machine we are having two types of centers are there. One is the live center and another is the dead center. Okay, that live centers is fixed into the headstock, and that dead center, it is fixed into the tailstock. Then first upon we have to observe the first specification related to the lathe machine is what is the distance between two centers. Means, see, this is the live center and this is the dead center. Okay, then we should observe the what is the distance between that both the center. Okay, because this specification of that lathe machine, it will give detailed information regarding to how much long workpiece. Okay, how much long workpiece we can hold in between that two center. Simple, distance between two centers means it is the distance between live center and dead center. Okay, and this specification it will give detailed information regarding to the how much long workpiece we can easily hold in between the live center and dead center. Okay, suppose the distance between the two centers are 50 centimeter. Okay, 50 centimeter. If the distance between that both the center is the 50 centimeter, and suppose we are having one long workpiece whose length is 60 mm, then this lathe machine is not suitable for this workpiece because its length is very high and this distance between that both the center, it is a 50 mm, okay, and we are knowing that long workpiece we are supporting with the help of that both the center, so that this machine is not applicable for this, na? Okay, for this purpose, okay, for this purpose we have to know what is the distance or what is the length between that, or what is the distance between that both the center. Okay, this specification give the information regarding to the how much long of workpiece we can easily hold in between that both the center, that is in the live center and in the dead center. Okay, then next specification of that lathe machine is maximum diameter hole, maximum diameter of hole which is passes through the headstock. See here inside that headstock, it consists of one hollow spindle is there. Okay, means inside that spindle there is the one hole is here, and that hole it will be throughout the headstock. That hole it will be throughout the headstock. Okay, suppose we are having very long workpiece is there, and that long workpiece it is not possible to hold in between that both the center. Okay, that time we can insert that long workpiece through this hole, and then we have to hold or support that long workpiece in between that both the center. Okay, here one hollow hole is here inside that headstock. That time this next specification is given information regarding to that what is the maximum diameter of that hollow hole which is passing through this headstock. Okay, suppose we are having workpiece of diameter 50 cm. Okay, suppose we are having one long workpiece is there, and that long workpiece it is not possible to hold between that both the center. Okay, in this condition we can insert such type of the long workpiece through this hollow hole. Okay, now for example, suppose we are having one workpiece whose dia is 50 cm. Okay, 50 cm, and the diameter of this hole. Okay, the diameter of this hollow hole which is passing through that headstock is 40 cm. Okay, 40 cm. Then tell me, this job we can hold through this hollow hole? No, we cannot pass. Okay, we cannot pass this workpiece of 50 cm diameter through this hollow hole because its diameter is maximum diameter is 40 mm. Okay, for this purpose, we should check what is the maximum diameter of that hole which is passing through the headstock, so that we can easily pass maximum diameter of workpiece through that hollow hole which is passing through that headstock. Okay, for this purpose we should check this specification. Okay, then next specification is bed length. Means we have to check what is the length of that bed, whether it is 50 cm, 100 cm, like this. Okay, what is the bed length? What will be the bed length? Okay, this is the third specification. Then next specification of that lathe machine is swing over the bed. It is important, swing over the bed. Then what is meant by the swing over the bed? See, that distance is called as a swing over the bed. See this distance. Okay, means how much maximum diameter of workpiece we can machine on that lathe machine. Okay, means see here, this specification number 4, it will give detail information regarding to the how much maximum diameter of workpiece we can easily machine on that lathe machine. Okay, see here, suppose we are having 50 cm. Suppose we are having a workpiece of 50 mm, 50 cm diameter. Okay, 50 cm diameter, and that workpiece suppose we have hold in between that check or that live center. Okay, if that workpiece is touched to that bed, if it is touched to that bed, that time it is not useful, na? It is useful? It is no useful. So that your workpiece should not be touched to that bed. Okay, suppose we have hold this workpiece inside that check, 50 centimeter diameter workpiece we have hold in that check. That time this half portion of that workpiece, it will be in this portion, and half portion of that workpiece, it will be in upward direction. Okay, म्हणजे ह्याच्यामध्ये आपण किती मॅक्झिमम डायमीटरचा वर्कपीस ह्याच्यामध्ये होल्ड करू शकतो की जो ह्या बेडला टच करणार नाही, दॅट लेंथ इज कॉल्ड एज द स्विंग ओव्हर द बेड. ओके, स्विंग ओव्हर द बेड मीन्स दिस स्पेसिफिकेशन गिव द इन्फॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग टू द वर्कपीस विल नॉट बी हिट टू द बेड. ओके, this specification or from that specification we can easily analyze whether that workpiece is touched to the bed or not. Okay, this is swing over the bed. The next specification of lathe machine is horsepower machine, means whether it is 3 HP machine is there, whether it is 5 HP machine is there, whether it is 7 HP machine is there, like this. Okay, if higher power, it will produce or it will remove the maximum amount of the material, like this. Okay, then speed range, what is the speed range of that machine? Okay, then we have to check what is the weight of that machine in the ton, so that we can easily analyze whether that machine we can move from one place to the another place. Okay, for this purpose we have to check what is the weight of that machine in the ton, and then we have to check what is the accuracy of that machine. If the accuracy is more, absolutely the price of that machine is also more. Okay, like this. Okay, these are the basic specification of the lathe machine. Once we have to observe that all the specification, we will get idea about which lathe machine we should purchase. Okay, during purchasing the any lathe machine, we should go through that all the specifications, so that we will get better idea for purchasing the lathe machine from the market. Okay, this is about the lathe machine. Okay, now the next point is CNC machine. Then what is meant by the CNC machine? Here, CNC means computer numerical control machine. C stand for computer, N stand for numerical control machine. Okay, CNC is nothing but computer numerical control machine. Then see the definition of that CNC machine, in which the function and motion of that machine tool. Okay, in the CNC machine, the function and motion of that CNC machine are controlled by prepared program. Okay, means the function and motion of that machine tool. Okay, inside that CNC machine, the function and motion of that machine tool we can control with the help of the program. Then what is meant by the program? Simple, program is nothing but it is the set of instructions. Means first upon it is necessary to prepare the one program. Program means it is the set of the instruction, and we have to prepare the program with the help of the some codes are there. Okay, in that CNC machine generally we can use G codes and M codes. Okay, with the help of that G code and with the help of that M code, first upon we have to prepare one program, means we have to prepare one set of instruction. Okay, then what is meant by that G code and M code? Okay, G code is nothing but it is the preparatory code, and M code is nothing but it is the miscellaneous code. Okay, then for example, G code means suppose like this, G00 code is there, then G01 code is there. Okay, G02 is there, like this. G03 is there, like this is there. Okay, whenever we want to perform the any operation, okay, whenever we want to perform the any operation, that time we can use this G codes. Okay, and whenever we want to control the motion of machine part, okay, suppose we want to control the motion of that machine part or to perform the machine part in operation of that machine part, that time we can use the M code. Means suppose we want to start the spindle, that time we can use the spindle is nothing but it is the part of machine. Okay, means we can rotate the spindle with the help of the M code. Okay, suppose we want to start the coolant on. Okay, it is the part of machine, that time we can use the M code. And suppose we want to move the spindle, or suppose we want to move the tool rapidly, suppose we want to move the tool in linearly means we want to remove the material, that time we have to use the G code. Okay, like this. With the help of that G code and M code, we have to prepare one program, and that program is nothing but it is the set of the instruction. And with the help of that program, okay, with the help of that program, we can easily control the function and motion of that machine. Okay, this is about the CNC machine. Now see, this is the one block diagram regarding to the CNC machine. This is the block diagram about that CNC machine. It consists of the input devices is there. Then it consists of the machine control unit is there. Then driving system is there. Then machine tool is there. Then feedback device is there. And display unit is there. Okay, these are the basic block diagram of that CNC machine. Now see how that CNC machine is work with the help of that block diagram. Okay, see here. The input devices. First upon, we have to give the input with the help of that input devices, and that input is nothing but it is set of instruction. Means first upon, we have to prepare the program with the help of that G code and M code, and that program we have to give to the machine control unit with the help of that input devices. Means we are giving the input to that CNC machine is nothing but program. Okay, program as input we have to give to that CNC machine. Then that input is given to the machine control unit. Okay, then what is the function of that machine control unit? Inside that machine control unit, whatever that instruction or whatever that set of instruction we have sent to that machine control unit, inside that machine control unit, the data processing work is going on or it is completed. Means that machine control unit, it will be carried out the processing on that data. Whatever data we have given to that machine control unit, okay, on that data, that machine control unit, it will be make processing and it will create the signal, and that signal from that machine control unit, it is given to the driving system. Okay, that in machine control unit, it will be carried out the processing on that data, on that input data, then it will convert rate, then it will give the particular signal to the driving system, and from the driving system, that signal is given to the machine tool, and with the help of that signal, that machine tool, it consists of different part, and that different parts are going to rotate. Okay, and to that machine tool here, to that machine tool, we have attached one feedback devices. Then what is function of that feedback devices? If there is okay, see here, then that feedback devices is attached to the machine tool, and what is the function of that feedback devices here? If suppose there is any error is created inside that machine tool, that feedback devices, it will be absorb that error, and that error in the form of signal, it is given to the machine control unit. Okay, again, on that error, that work is carried out inside that machine control unit, and that correct signal, okay, the correct signal is given to the machine tool, and that again machine tool, it will be work properly. Okay, in this manner, your CNC machine is working. Okay, in this fashion or in this manner, your CNC machine is working. Now see here, what is the advantages of that CNC machine? Advantages of that CNC machine. Okay, now see here, the advantages of that CNC machine. First advantages of that CNC machine is higher flexibility. Okay, then with the help of that CNC machine, we can easily increase the productivity, because the time required for produce any product with the help of that CNC machine, it very less time is required for performing the any operation or any production, so that we can produce the number of product. Means we can increase the productivity with the help of that CNC machine. Then consistent quality. Okay, that CNC machine, okay, once inside that CNC machine, of that CNC machine, it will be produced consistent quality. Then what is meant by that consistent quality? Means suppose we have produced number of work, number of product. Okay, if the accuracy of that product number one is some, suppose 0.1, then the accuracy of that all the whatever parts or whatever product are produced by that CNC machine are same. Means the accuracy of all the product are same, similarly. Okay, it is called as consistency quality. Then reduce crap. Okay, reduce the crap.
because all the operations, okay, are carried out with the help of that sensing machine are automatically, so that there is no question for the any scrap. Okay, so that with the help of the CNC machine, with the help of that CNC machine, we can easily reduce the scrap rate. Scrap rate. Okay, means there is no any wastage is done in that with the help of that CNC machine. Then reliable operation is produced with the help of that CNC machine. Then next, it reduces the non-productive time. Okay, with the help of that CNC machine, we can reduce the non-productive time also. Then reduce the manpower, because reduce the manpower, because suppose we want to carry out the any operation or any product with the help of the conventional machine, to operate that conventional machine onto conventional machine, the number of persons are required. Okay, but with the help of that CNC machine, only single person can handle the number of CNC machine. Okay, suppose one operator can handle two or three CNC machine at a time, so that with the help of that CNC machine, we can reduce the manpower also. Then short cycle time is here. Then it will produce the high accuracy product. Then reduce the lead time. Okay. Then inside the, or with the help of that CNC machine, we can make the handling of that material automatically. Okay. That material handling also make automatically. Then it required lesser floor space. Then increase the operation safety. Okay, that CNC machine it will give the high safety. Means suppose inside that CNC machine we can use different types of the switches, and that switches it will be provide the operation safety. Okay, then machining of advanced material. Okay, that suppose we want to carry out the machining on the advanced material, and that advanced machining on that material, it is not possible with the help of that conventional machine, and such type of the machining on that advanced material we can easily carry out with the help of the CNC machine. Okay, these are the basic advantages of the CNC machine. Then what are the disadvantages of that CNC machine? Okay, now see here. This is the disadvantages of that CNC machine. And then first disadvantages of that CNC machine is it required high cost. Okay, that setup of that CNC machine is costly, and to operate that CNC machine, we have to require the skilled operator. That unskilled operator cannot operate the CNC machine. This is the disadvantages. Means suppose we want to operate the CNC machine, we have to require the qualified person. Okay, qualified person, skilled operator is required to handling that CNC machine, and the setup cost of that CNC machine is very high. Okay, then to handle that CNC machine, or for that CNC machine, it required the computers, programming knowledge is required. Okay, to handle the CNC machine, we have to require the some knowledge about the computer, and also we have to require the some knowledge about the programming. Then how to perform that program, or how to prepare that program. Okay, such type of the knowledge is also required to perform the operation with the help of that CNC machine. Then maintenance is difficult. Okay, maintenance of that CNC machine is very difficult. Then machine have to install in air conditioned place. Okay, it is necessary to install that CNC machine in air conditioned place. Okay, air conditioned place is required for that CNC machine. Okay, these are the basic disadvantages of that CNC machine. Now see, what are the basic application of that CNC machine? Okay, what are the basic application of CNC machine? Here we should use the CNC machine, or where we can use the CNC machine. See here, okay, see here the application of that CNC machine. Okay, see here we can use the CNC machine. Okay, generally we can use the CNC machine in the metal cutting industry. Okay, see here, the part with the complicated counters are there. Okay, suppose we are having many complicated parts are there, and suppose we want to carry out the
machining operation on that part. Okay, for this such type of the part we can use the CNC machine. Okay, then the part requiring close tolerance and good repeatability. Okay, suppose we want to, okay, whenever we want very high or close tolerance is required. Okay, whenever we want to very close tolerance are required, that time we can use the CNC machine. Okay, when there is a complicated parts are there, that time we can use the CNC machine, or whenever we want to very close tolerance are required, in this case also we can use the CNC machine. Then next application of that CNC machine, where we can use the CNC machine, the part requiring expensive jig and fixture. Okay, if it is produced by the conventional machine, suppose we are having one workpiece is there, and suppose we want to carry out the different types of operation on that workpiece with the help of the conventional machine. Okay, to perform the different types of operation on that workpiece with the help of the conventional machine, in this such case we have to require the high costly jigs and fixture. Okay, for such type of the job we can perform the operation with the help of the CNC machine in less cost. Then next application where we can use the CNC machine, the part that may have several engineering changes such as during the development. Okay, means suppose we are having such type of the parts are there, and during the or for such type of the part there may be change of the something is changing. Okay, for such type of the part also we can use the CNC machine. Okay, then in case here human errors could be extremely costly, means suppose there may be chances of occurring the human error during the operations. Okay, suppose we are having such type of the operations are there, and during to perform that such type of the operation, suppose we have to use the manpower, and due to that man there may be chances of increasing or suppose we can say creating the number of errors, there may be chances of creating the number of errors. Okay, for such type of the operation or for such type of the parts we can use the CNC machine. Okay, because in that CNC machine there may be less chances of occurring the less error, because the all operation we are performing the automatically, so that there is no chances of occurring the error. So that there may be whenever there is a high chances of occurring the error for such type of the product or for such type of the operation, we can use the CNC machine, because CNC machine it will be minimize the error. Then the part that are needed in hurry. Okay, hurry means we want to produce a product in very less time. Okay, in this condition also, because within a less period we cannot produce that product with the help of the conventional machine. Okay, suppose we want to produce the very fastly production, suppose we want to carry out the production very fastly, that time we can use the CNC machine, because it is impossible to produce the product very fastly with the help of the conventional machine. Okay, then the small batches or lot or for the short production also we can use the CNC machine. Okay, these are the basic application here we can use the CNC machine. Okay, now once again I will summarize which point we have taken in today's lecture. We have studied regarding to the specification of the lathe machine. Okay, then what is meant by the specification? The specification is nothing but it will give the detailed description regarding to that product, means it will give information regarding to the dimension, materials. Okay, such type of the description we will get inside that specification. Okay, and whenever we want to purchase any product, we are knowing that the first step is, first upon we will see the what is the specification of that particular product. In similar manner also we should check the what are the specification of the lathe machine. If that specification of that particular product or specification of that lathe machine are suitable to us, then and then only we will purchase the lathe machine. Then what are the specification of that lathe machine? See here, there are the number of specifications are there. First specification of that lathe machine is the distance between two centers, means we have to check what is the distance between that both the center. What are that both the center? What is the distance between the live center and dead center? Okay, with the help of that specification we can easily analyze how much long workpiece we can easily hold in between that both the center. Okay, for this purpose first upon we should check first specification, that is distance between the both the center. Then next specification is maximum diameter of hole which is passing through the headstock. See here, inside that hailstock there is the hello spindle is there, and through that hello spindle there is a one hello pull is provided through that hailstock. Okay, through that hailstock there is one hello pull is there, and with the help of that pull we can insert the very very long workpiece is there. That workpiece we cannot hold in between that both the center. Such type of the workpiece we can easily pass through that hole, and then we can hold in between that both the center. Okay, with the help of that center and dead center, and with the help of that check also. Okay, for this purpose we have to check what is the diameter of that hole which is passing through that headstock. Okay, what is the diameter means how much maximum diameter of hole we can easily pass through that headstock hole. That information we will get from this specification. Then we have to check what is the length of that bed. Okay, what is meant by that bed? Bed is nothing but it is the main part of your lathe machine, and on that bed the whatever parts of that lathe machines are there, that all part of that lathe machines are bolted with your bed. So that we should check the what is the length of that bed. Okay, then next specification is the swing over the bed. With the help of that specification we can analyze how much maximum diameter of workpiece we can easily machine on that lathe machine, or it will give the information regarding to the whether your workpiece is touching to that bed or not. With the help of that specification we can easily analyze. Then next specification of that lathe machine is HP power, means horsepower of that machine. Okay, then speed range, then what is the weight of that lathe machine in the turn, and finally we have to check what is the accuracy of that lathe machine. If the higher accuracy is there, then its price is also more. Okay, that specification we have to check during purchasing the lathe machine. Then we have discussed regarding to the CNC machine. Okay, then what is meant by the CNC machine? CNC machine is nothing but it is the computer numerical control machine is there, and okay, what is meant by the CNC machine? It is the computer numerical control machine. In such type of the machine we can control the function and motion of that machine tool with the help of prepared programs. Okay, what is meant by the program? Program is nothing but it is the set of the instruction. That program we have to okay. See, what is meant by the program? Prepared program is nothing but it is the set of the instruction. First upon we have to prepare the program with the help of the G code and M code. What is meant by the G code? G code means a preparatory code, M code means a miscellaneous code. Okay, with the help of that code we have to prepare the program, and then that program we have to feed to the machine control unit as the input. Okay, inside that machine control unit the processing of that input is carried out, and then signal from that machine control unit it is given to the driving system, and then from the driving system it is given to the machine tool, means your whatever that rotating parts are there, that part of that particular machine is going to rotate, and that machine will be perform the operation. Okay, to that machine tool again we have to attach one feedback systems. That feedback system is what? If there is any error is created inside that machine, that error it will be absorbed by that feedback system, and the signal from that feedback system it is again given to the machine control unit. Again on that error that work is carried out inside that machine control unit, and the correct signal from that machine control unit it is given to the machine tool, and then again your machine tool is going to work properly. Okay, this is the basic line diagram, or we can say this the block diagram of your CNC machine. Then advantages of the CNC machine means what are the advantages? Simple advantages: with the help of the CNC machine we can increase the productivity. Okay, then we can reduce the non-productive time, manpower also we can reduce. Okay, we can achieve the high accuracy. Okay, and also we'll get the higher safety with the help of that CNC machine. And what are the disadvantages of that CNC machine? Okay, because the setup cost of that CNC machine is very high. Then to operate the CNC machine we have to require the skilled operator. Okay, again we should know the knowledge about the computers and programming. Okay, that computer and programming knowledge is also required to handling that CNC machine. Then maintenance is difficult to that CNC machine, and to machine we have to install in the air conditioned places. Okay, These are the basic disadvantages of your CNC machine. Then application of the CNC machine. Where we can use the application? Or sorry, where we can use the CNC machine? Okay. The part which are very complicated to perform the operation on the such type of the component, we can use the CNC machine. Then we can use the CNC machine whenever we required very close tolerance is there. Means we have to require the higher accuracy is required. Okay, whenever we have to require the higher accuracy product, that time we have to use the CNC machine, because with the help of the conventional machine we cannot achieve that much accuracy. Okay, because CNC machine it will provide the higher accuracy. Means whenever we have to require the higher accuracy, that time we can use the, or for such type of the product also we can use the CNC machine. Okay, then we can use the CNC machine for the operation or for the product. Okay, there may be chances of the higher error it will be occur. Okay, for minimizing the error, or whenever we want to less human error, it will be occur with the help of that CNC machine. Okay, whenever there is a more chances of occurring the human error for such type of the job or for such type of the operation, we should use the CNC machine. Okay, then we require, or whenever we want to high very fast production is required. Okay, very fast production is required. For that fast production we can use the CNC machine, because that very fast production we cannot produce with the help of that conventional machine. Okay, for such type of the application we can use the CNC machine. Okay, thank you.